Nicky, I'm down here at the cloud in Auckland's Viaduct, 6 months out from the World Masters Games. A lot of people competing in the World Masters Games. It's all that great. Brian Williams. Now, we'll talk to Brian soon about the World Masters Games. But firstly, we've got a test on the weekend. All Blacks going for 18 in a row in the world record. Today, Steve Hansen said the 67 team is his favourite ever team. He thought they were the best. Where do you think these guys stand?
Oh, they're right up there. No doubt about it. Last 5 years, two Rugby World Cups, and the manner in which they're playing now and the manner of big margin victories is just tremendous. They're right up there, for sure.
Maybe the best?
Maybe the best, but it's all hypothetical, isn't it?
It sure is. Now, the World Masters Games. 25,000 odd athletes down here in Auckland in 6 months' time. You're one of them. What are you competing in?
Well, I'm going in the bowls and the golf. I thought about the rugby for about 10 seconds, maybe 12 seconds. I thought, nah.
So who can compete in this? Can anyone be involved?
Well, you have to be over a certain age group, and the age groups are different for each event. For example, the women rugby players over 27, rugby over 30, over 40, and over 50. So different categories. 28 different sports, 45 different venues. So it's going to be fantastic.
Pretty big as well. Nikki, you know, seems like I'm old enough to be a master as well. Maybe you should compete in this as well.
Thanks, Ross. Yes, there's no question. I probably am old enough to compete. Anyway, on the sport, Lionel Messi has again displayed his world-class pedigree, scoring a hat-trick in Barcelona.
Well, I didn't actually kill anyone. I tried to.
You know what? I'm tired. I have a headache. I have a lot of work to do. My back hurts. It's that time of the month. I have another meeting.
All right, Stan, don't be nervous. This place is a sure thing.
I'm going to do it this time, guys.
Good. Now, if you start to get nervous, picture them naked. You start to get really nervous, make them get naked. Still nervous, you get naked. You can do whatever you want. You're killing these people.
Oh, good. You're here. Come on in. We're in a bit of a hurry. We have to catch a comment. Now, according to the laws of Zargon, we need an outsider to deliver the poison which will return us to our home planet. And you must be the chosen one, since you were the first to reply to our post on Craigslist.
How awesome is Craigslist? That's how I met my hiking buddy, and that bitch who stole all my stuff.
Okay, now, which one of you will be releasing us to freedom?
Our boy Stan, right here.
Is there a problem?
What are you waiting for?
Hurry up!
Is this the first time you poisoned a bunch of people?
Come on, do it, do it, do it!
Right now is my acting class. How about you have my scene partner?
So, I like your shower caps. Sounds crazy right away. There you are. I've been calling your cell all morning. I got you a part in a snuff film. You'll be killing Stacy Keach. What is this? I don't get this.
I was picking blueberries for peace with my daughter. Who was I kidding? I'm just a whipping non-killer who doesn't have the guts to end another human's life.
I'll set up the juicer so we can make half of these smoothies.
Yay.
I see you've noticed our unitards. We're trying out for gymnastics.
That's right. I'm defying you with a handspring.
Come to my desk and sit there, you know, and I'm not going to stop. I've got you know, on my own now.
Good luck. Wish me luck on bottling my own preserves. My blueberries.
Look at yourself. Look at what you've become. You're not going to find the one picking blueberries.
Give it up, Roger. There is no one. That person doesn't exist. No one is just going to magically fall in my lap. The guy who came to my house. This whole time I was going out looking for it, but it was right down the street, living with its mother and watching The Sandlot on DVD.
Stan?
It was right there, and I couldn't even see it.
Stan?
I guess that's why it's perfect. You don't even realize it's happening.
Stan!
What?
Steve just rode away in that pedophile's ice cream truck.
Oh my God. He had ice cream at lunch?
Yeah, sorry, yes.
Are you Randy's mother? I need to find your son. He drove off with my boy.
Oh, dear. Randy used to work at the water park before the troubles. You might want to check there. He also killed Kat! So, you know.
Oh,
bringing us, Randy.
No problem. Hey, do you kids sometimes kiss your pillow and pretend it's one of the little rascals?
No.
Me neither. How'd you boys like to see the old mattress in my secret spy lair behind the waterfall?
Yeah!
I
need to take it quickly. My son is about to be molested.
$65.
65? That's outrageous.
If you have a soda can, you get in for half price.
Right, no, it's not.
I know my son's still about to be molested. I need a half price ticket.
I'm sorry, I can't accept the full can. It has to be empty.
Polar bears shouldn't give this to their babies.
All right, clear a path. Some people work for a living.
You guys need tickets.
CIA.
Wow, that bums me out.
Harry Ellis, Pollard owner, out of my way.
Sure, they told us what happened. We got here as soon as we could.
Spread out and find the boys. There's not a moment to lose.
Sanchez Montezuma, INS, Churro and Sophia Division. I'm confiscating all these churros.
And a milk, please.
Isn't playing popcorn fun?
Something doesn't seem right here.
Yeah, at the very least, we should have popped by now.
I'm the salt. All colonels have to wrestle me to get salted.
Freeze, dirtbag!
Dad!
It's all over, Randy. Time to die.
Okay, yeah, I get it.
Aren't you going to apologize and beg for your life?
No. Look, I'm a sex offender. I love offensive sex. I offend people with the sex I have. That's who I am, and that's who I'll always be.
My God, boys. We can all take a page from Randy the Molester's book. He's comfortable with who he is. And I should be as well. So I'm not a killer. If it happens for me, I kill someone, great. If not, fine. But it's not going to be what defines me. I don't need to kill someone to prove anything to you, myself, or anyone else.
Thanks for saving us. I'm sorry for the way I acted. Just because you haven't killed anyone doesn't mean you're not a great dad. Yeah, that's nice.
You're going away for a long time, Randy.
Not as long as you might think.
What do you mean?
Well, I've got a great lawyer and my mom's got a ton of money. I'll be back out on the streets in no time.
I don't think so. Once again, Bad Larry, I am so sorry.
I can't believe you fired a shot that completely missed Randy and went through the waterfall hitting Bad Larry, who was on the other side. But, I'm just trying to make sure we're all clear.
Oh, I'm not gonna make it. See, Sam? It was me all along. I was your one, and you didn't even know it.
Bad Larry.
Hey, no tears, you. I am one bad.
I'll never forget you, Bad Larry. You'll always be my first.
I'm glad it was me. And I shall become more powerful than you could possibly imagine.
What do you mean by that?
Who cares? He's dead.
I know it's just a corn dog, but you'll never forget it. Where did I park my car?
Go to hell, Haley. That's not who I am. Now, go take off that unitard or I'll kill you.
You still would. Did you kill someone?
Yep.
Did you wash the blood off your hands?
I sure didn't, honey. I sure didn't.
Here it is. My big chance. Last line of the show. Oh, I've got an area. Something about Rutger Hauer. No. Wait. No! No, that's not what you stop! Thank you.
We've got a FedEx day tomorrow. That's going to be fun. What's that? Oh. Maya.
We've got a slight problem here because I have been rather naughty.
What are you doing? Santa? You can't leave now. This slobbering, onion-eyed magpie thinks he can just blow me off like that. He's got another thing coming.
Why do you want to go all the way to the North Pole?
Because I'm going to kill Santa Claus. I've got it all planned out. I'm going to see the workshop, head a few reindeer, take a few pictures of me and Santa, and then I'm going to blow his brains out. Hopefully with his bitch wife watching. This can't be it. This can't be Santa's workshop. This looks like Bridgeport, Connecticut.
And then, you know what day you're going to get that home then?
No, I don't know.
Oh, I thought you were going to know what I'm going.
No, they haven't replied to me yet. My email.
Oh, okay.
Whatever sort of trick this is, I will not be deterred. I'm not leaving until Santa Claus is dead by my hand.
Oh my God! You're Santa Claus.
Yeah? Who are you?
I'm Stewie Griffin, and I'm going to kill you.
Oh, thank God.
What?
Do it. Please, put me out of my misery.
You want me to kill you? There isn't a great deal of sport in that. Oh, my God. Are you all right?
Not okay. Not okay. I just need to catch my breath.
I don't understand. I thought you were supposed to be jolly and happy.
I used to be, a long time ago. I made toys for little boys and girls. I loved my work, and they loved me. But it just got out of hand. The world's population kept growing and growing. Kids wanted more toys, fancier toys. We used to make wooden choo-choos and rag dolls. You ever try to make an iPod? I've got orders for millions of them.
Oh, that reminds me. I need a new version of Quicken.
Look at the toxic waste we're producing. I think the toxins are taking even more of a toll than the inbreeding. Inbreeding? Take a look. I started with one family of magic elves, and every year I needed more and more to keep up. Now they're just a sickly race of mutated genetic disasters. At least 60% of them are born blind. The workload destroys them, but they don't know anything else. It's gotten so their instincts take over, and near the end, they just walk out into the snow and die. And the reindeer ate them, which has turned the reindeer into wild, feral creatures with a bloodlust for elf flesh. I don't even pray for them anymore. Seems pointless. What god would allow this?
This is in none of the songs or poetry. It's a horror show up here. How could you let this happen?
Me? Well, I didn't do this. Christmas.
Nightmares and black icy stairs.
little elf used to fill up a shelf making playthings and selflessly thrilling us. Now that I crack at it, feels like you're wrecked. Christmas time is killing us.
While a train only rises the pain of the world that's failing and thrilling us.
Fingers all bleed and look, that guy just bleeding. Cause Christmas time is killing us.
But can't you see our point of view? We rely on you. Can't you see that Christmas cheer gets us through the year?
My whole crew is black and blue. Can't you take a clue? You may think I look great, but I'm 28. Jingle bell is a requiem bell, and well, think it's swell, we are toiling in hell. Take a look, you can tell, as a man I'm a shell. Because Christmas time is killing us. Killing us! Christmas time is killing us.
So Brian and Stewie found Santa Claus, but he sure wasn't what they expected. It turned out the increasing demands of Christmas had all but destroyed the poor old man. Okay, look at this. Somebody gave me a little remote-controlled helicopter. Pretty cool, eh? Broken.
I don't know, boys. He's in rough shape.
But Doctor, you've got to do something for him. It's Christmas Eve.
Christmas is the problem. He can't keep his pace up anymore. If he goes out tonight, he'll die.
Well, then who's going to deliver all the presents?
We will.
What?
Stewie, look, you were right. Santa is real. And he needs our help. Don't worry, Santa. We'll make sure there's a Christmas this year.
Thank you, Brian. That brings me peace in this hour. I'll be with Allah soon.
What?
He doesn't know what he's saying. He's delirious. Look, you better get moving. All right, Stewie, let's go get the sleigh ready.
Someone else is a little freaked out by that policy.
Never mind that. Let's just get going.
All right, Brian, let's do this. Come on. Give me up. Come on, you dumb deer.
It's not working. They need to be coaxed. Santa said they eat elf flesh.
Excuse me, sir? Mr. Elf, sir? Hello? Young man? I don't think he even knows where he is.
Do you want to just...
Yeah, I mean, I'll just try and do it, I guess. Hey. Hey, Bella?
Jane, every mention that we've got
But you will notice the great new taste of our finest coffee ever. Try our best cup yet. Available now at the cafe drive-thru. MasterCard from KiwiBank. It has the lowest purchase interest rate of all our credit cards. And right now, there's no account fee for 12 months. Apply online using promo code KB123.
Want to make life a little crazier? With Mercury, you can save up to $500 on an e-bike. It's just one way we're making energy more wonderful.
clean his father's beaten head off it.
Hey there, how you doing?
Who are you?
I'm Santa.
You're Santa?
Who are you? Where's Dan? Oh my god!
Oh crap! Quick, screw it, get a rat!
Help! Help! Mommy!
It's okay.
Brian, see if you can find some duct tape. Oh my god.
Excuse me, sir.
Thank you.
top story tonight? Barack Obama makes a visit to James Woods High School.
Yes, it's time to get jiggy with it, Cohog. I thought we had taken that out. President Barack Obama will visit James Woods High next month, and this little town of ours couldn't be more abuzz.
Oh my God, this is going to be so amazing. It's all anybody in my class is talking about.
Darn it, why is this so hard?
What's wrong, Chris?
Just because Obama's coming, everybody in my English class has to write a stupid essay about hope. This is all I can come up with.
Chris, this is just a shaded in triangle on the word month.
For God's sakes, Meg, it's a first draft. Just tell me if you think the tone is right.
But I don't know what this is, but it's not what hope is about, Chris.
Well, if you're such a genius, you tell me what hope is.
Hope is what gets you out of bed in the morning when it's the day of prom and you haven't been asked. Hope pushes the caterpillar through the cocoon and drives the salmon upstream. Your breast may be small and your glasses may be thick, but hope doesn't hold up a mirror. Hope is a horizon we head for, leaving nothing behind us but fear. And though we may never reach our goals, it's hope that will save us from who we once were.
Wow. Did you learn that at school?
No. You can't just learn creative writing, Chris. It's got to be inside you, like musical talent or athleticism or the ability to choose to be gay.
I don't think they choose that.
Oh, please, they choose that.
Hey, what's up, crowded people? What the hell are these things? Curtains or something? Boring! Holy smoke, it's crowded in here!
Hey!
Yeah, oh, that's a rip. It opens up the whole room.
Peter, there you are. Where the hell have you been? I've been worried sick.
That's right. I have your Red Bulls from New York. What's your big deal? Hey, here's my room, man!
Wow, Dad, that was pretty cool. Can I try some Red Bull?
Oh, yeah, you didn't try some Red Bull. First, I take it as an insult. If you didn't, here you go. Have some kids. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Take it. That's what he went back to say. All right, I'm going to try and milk the cow.
Hey, now, why did you get that cow?
Oh, that's a silly question, Lois. I bought it so we can have fresh milk every day. Oh, boy, that Red Bull's a strong scum.
Everybody, welcome back to The Price is Right. Time to spin the wheel. Top winner for the day is Peter, so you're going to be the first to spin it. Go ahead, Peter. Of course, you can't do a dollar without going over. All right, well, we're waiting for the wheel to spin. You want to say hi to anybody?
Oh, yeah, cool. I want to say hi to Lois, Brian, Chris, Dewey, Meg, Joe, Bonnie, Craig, Mike, Cleveland, Mort, Seamus, Adam West, Dr. Hartman, Bruce, Carter, Babs, Tom, Tucker, Angela, Opie, Carl, Herbert, Jillian, Consuela, Giant Chicken, Chris, help that guy.
Okay, sure, they're not going to hear that.
Whoa, paramedics, come on down!
Oh my gosh,
it's
right! Oh,
God, get the
body. You know that essay about hope I had to write? Well, the principal said it was the best one in the class, and he wants me to read it aloud to introduce the president.
Oh, Chris, that's incredible. Remember when I used to come to school to wipe you, and I'd say, someday I won't have to wipe you anymore, and you'll do great things. Well, this has been a big year for us.
Wait a second, give me that. Hope pushes the caterpillar through the cocoon and drives the salmon upstream.
I wrote that. You sold it for me.
Hey, you didn't say I couldn't use it.
But now you get to meet the president of the United States because of what I wrote. Oh, I bet you don't even know what his first name is.
I don't know. Mike?
Hey, what are you doing?
Lois, where is my Red Bull?
Peter, I'm not afraid of it.
Why the hell would you do that?
It was making you crazy, and it's not good for you. That's why I poured it all out in the garden. Hello. Bye.
Official flower business.
What are you doing, Peter?
Hello.
I'm making my own
Red Bull. How are you?
Can't stop me from experiencing the manic highs and lows my body demands.